So now that we saw how gradient descent works in the previous video, we are one step closer to stochastic gradient descent, which is a special variant of gradient descent. And as we will see in the upcoming units, stochastic gradient descent is the main component of backpropagation, which is the most popular learning algorithm for deep neural networks. But let's not get ahead of ourselves and see how stochastic gradient descent works. So in the previous video, we saw the gradient descent algorithm where we did a parameter update after each epoch. Now, stochastic gradient descent is the flavor of gradient descent with essentially more frequent updates. So here's an outline of the stochastic gradient descent algorithm, and it is very similar to gradient descent with the main difference that we make an update after each training example. So similar to before, we have multiple training epochs, and in each training epoch, we iterate over each training example. Then we compute the output using the sigmoid activation function and compute the loss between the output and the actual class label. In gradient descent, we then kept updating the loss over the whole training epoch before we computed the gradients. In contrast, here in stochastic gradient descent, we compute the gradient of the loss for a single training example. And then using this loss, we update the model parameters. So in essence, what we are doing here is we are updating the model after each training example. So the stochastic gradient descent algorithm is essentially an approximation of gradient descent. And the rationale behind it is that we have more frequent updates when we iterate over the data set. However, updating the model after each training example is also not ideal, because now each loss is an approximation of the overall loss. And for using just one training example, we can get pretty rough approximations here. So to improve these approximations and also to make use of linear algebra concepts to speed up the training, there's a concept called mini-batch gradient descent, which is the flavor of stochastic gradient descent. So you can think of mini-batch gradient descent as a hybrid between the gradient descent algorithm and the stochastic gradient descent algorithm that we just introduced. So just to recap, in gradient descent, we make one model update per training epoch. In stochastic gradient descent, we make n model updates for each training epoch, where n is the number of examples in the dataset. Now, mini-batch gradient descent is essentially a hybrid between gradient descent and stochastic gradient descent. So in mini-batch gradient descent, we form these small groups or batches of training examples, and we will make one update after each batch. So what would be the optimal size for these small mini-batches? So mini-batch sizes are, again, a tuning parameter similar to the learning rate alpha that we discussed before. And don't worry about it too much yet. In upcoming units, we will actually learn about some smart code implementations that help us to find good values for the learning rate and the mini-batch size automatically. But yeah, if you are curious, typical mini-batch sizes are usually powers of 2. And this has something to do with GPU architecture, because in deep learning, we want to make efficient use of our hardware. If you are interested in these details, we will provide you with additional resources where you can find out more. Let's now get back to the mini-batch algorithm and see how it works. So similar to gradient descent and stochastic gradient descent, we iterate over the training epochs. However, what's new here is that we have a for loop over the mini-batches. So that's the number of mini-batches in the training epoch. However, everything nested under the mini-batch for loop is essentially identical to gradient descent. So what we have here is this overall loss as a placeholder that we set to 0. And then for each training example, we update this overall loss term. Or in other words, we are computing the loss for all the data points in the mini-batch here. So in gradient descent, we did the same computation over the whole epoch. And here the only difference is that we only consider those training examples that are in the mini-batch. So once we computed the overall loss for the mini-batch, we then, similar to before, compute the gradient of the loss and use it to update the model parameters. And what's actually nice is that we can say that the gradients from these mini-batches are unbiased estimates of the gradients, and that's because they don't systematically deviate from the calculation of the gradients on the whole dataset. Yeah, so just to recap, the advantage of mini-batch gradient descent over the regular stochastic gradient descent algorithm is that in mini-batch gradient descent, the updates will be less noisy. And the advantage of mini-batch gradient descent over regular gradient descent is that here we have more updates per epoch, so the model will learn much faster. Furthermore, as we will also see later, mini-batch gradient descent results in a much better GPU utilization, and it lets us take advantage of certain concepts of linear algebra. So now that we understand the training method of logistic regression and saw that it involves gradients, let's see how we can compute these gradients. And for that, we will actually use PyTorch, which can compute these gradients automatically for us.